بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. This is day 3 of keeping Jahannam at bay. Today I will discuss with you a small reminder about Surah Al-An'am, Ayah 108. That is Surah number 6, Al-An'am, and the Ayah I'm going to talk about is 108. الله تبارك وتعالى says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، ولا تسبوا الذين يدعون من دون الله فيسبوا الله عدوا بغير علم، كذلك زينا لكل أمة عملهم ثم إلى ربهم مرجعهم فينبئهم بما كانوا يعملون. And then there's translation of this ayah here. الله تبارك وتعالى forbids us, as in Imam al-Tabari says in Ibn Kathir, to insult any deity that is worshipped by other people other than Allah. And the reason why this, and do not insult those they invoke or worship other than Allah. And the reason, lest they insult Allah in enmity without knowledge. Thus, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has made pleasing to every community their deeds. Then to the Lord is their return, and He will inform them about what they used to do. What this ayah means, my brother, today Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in the Quran has forbade us, for example, if we see somebody worshipping a cross, it is haram in Islam, haram to insult the cross and tell him, why are you worshiping? That is just a piece of wood. Why would you insult that? And you start belittling his God. The reason, he can turn to you and start insulting Islam and insulting Allah. And guess what? When you do that, you will pick up the broken pieces for all the deed that you have done. You get all the sayyat. Now, someone might say, Rasulullah ﷺ used to insult the area. He did not insult the deities of Quraysh. Quraysh understood his action as an insult. Rasulullah ﷺ didn't insult. And then they explained what it was to them. أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَا إِلَهًا. Has he made all these gods one single god? So to them it was an insult that all these different duties that the divinities that they worshipped were doing different things. All that could be done by one god. It means the other ones were useless. So that was where the insult. But Rasulullah ﷺ did not insult. And this also explains why Rasulullah didn't do like Sheikh Ahmed did that, alayhi rahmatullah, and Zaki Naik now, who is like in these confrontational things. He is Mr. Know-it-all. This is a problem. This is a problem. When someone appoints himself as the authority in Islam, then if he makes one mistake, that's it. We pay the price for it all. Today, Islam has been translated into English, and the English people have more knowledge. The new generation is growing with Muslims. Non-Muslims are working with Muslims, and they find that we Muslims are schizophrenic. We have more than a personality. We have the wherever you go, everyone is telling you to be like the Sahaba. We can't be like the Sahaba. No one tells us, be human. You can make mistakes, and you can repent. But just don't make too many mistakes without repenting, because you don't know what death is going to strike. Rasulullah ﷺ could have brought could have brought the Jews and the Christians. And he could have brought the original text from the sky, from Allah. Allah could have descended the Bible and the Torah on Rasulullah, the authentic ones. And Rasulullah could have pointed to the Jews and the Christians, this is your book. Follow this book, you will find me. I am written here, here, here. This is halal, this is halal, this is haram. What you're doing here is halal. That's what he could have. But why didn't Allah do that? Because the point of all this is not about you showing them that you are better than them. Because Allah has, as it is said in this ayah here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَذَلِكَ زَيَّنَّا لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ عَمَلَهُمْ. Allah has made beautiful, Allah has decorated the act of worship to these people. Allah has made pleasing, Allah has made it to, if you go to someone in India who worships a cow. To you, a cow is a cow. What? Worshiping a cow? But to him, it's a beautiful act. He's getting closer to Allah with it. Allah has made it for him seem like that. At the end of the day, it is Allah who has decorated that act for him. It is Allah who has made him worship the cow to have that belief. You go to someone who was the other day, someone came to me and he goes, how come these English people not believe in Allah? And to me, that was the most peculiar, the most strange question a Muslim can ask. Muslims, they ourselves, we believe in Allah and we are not obeying him as we should. Why do we expect of the others to do what we don't do ourselves? My brothers and my sisters, a Christian worships Jesus. I have no right to launch an attack on him that your religion is rubbish, that your religion, you worship in a human being. Rasulullah didn't do this to the Christians in his time. The best way, Allah has pointed us to how to make da'wah to these people. Call them to the worship of Allah. Don't pinpoint the deficiencies and the discrepancies in their book. Because even in our Islam, in Al-Quran, how do we have the Shia? How do we have the Sufis? How do we have so many different sects? How come a Salafi doesn't say Salamu Alaikum to a Muslim who doesn't have a beard? How did he misunderstand the text? It's because, ya akhi, we have different understandings. We have different understandings. Each one of us has been beautified his understanding. The danger is how to make sure that your understanding is correct. Don't think yourself by being Muslim you have the authority to insult other people's beliefs. Be respectful. If you see a Jew reading the Torah, don't mock his book because he's going to turn to you. Today, we have the Quran, the meanings of the Quran translated into English and pushed down the throat of so many of you that the English has suddenly become Quran. This is kufr, this is disbelief to give the Quran another language than that of Allah. Yet many of you accept at subconscious level what is in English is a Quran. How will you tell Allah when you meet him on the day of Qiyamah? What will you say to him? My brothers, the English people can read and the Quran is available online. And I have seen it with my eyes now. The English people have started doing to Islam what Muslims have been doing for Christianity for years. You say in this ayah, in this verse here of the chapter, for example, yeah, example chapter 2, verse 30. In this translation of this, it says this. In the translation of that, it says this. In the version, and they're going to treat the Quran like they treat the Bible. In the Sadiq Khan version, it says this. In Yusuf Ali version, it says that. In Imran, it says that. In Pictol, it says that. Which copies of the Quran is authentic? And you fall in the same trap that we Muslims have been digging to the Christians for years. A direct challenge means nothing. I pray to Allah tabaraka ta'ala to forgive all those who started this comparative religions. It was not something that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. The point was to call people to Islam. So from now on, do not insult anything that is worshipped beside Allah. Allah has forbade us. And if you become the cause that someone insults Islam, insults Allah for your own doings, then you will have to answer to Allah on the day of Qiyamah. And again, I will repeat the ayah. And in the meanings of, وَلَا تَسُبُّوا الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. And do not insult any other deity that they worship besides Allah. Because, so that they don't insult Allah in transgression and without knowledge. Kadharik, the reason why they worship and they love and they do everything that they do to their deity is because Allah has beautified that act for them. But on the day of Qiyamah, they will return to Allah. فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ, and Allah will reveal to them whatever they were doing, and it is Allah to judge them. So please, my brother, from now on, don't think you are superior to an English. I've seen people, it's sick. How Muslims speak about the non-Muslims in the masjid. And then when they go out, they live in hypocrisy. They go to claim their benefits and they do this. And when they have a problem, they go to a non-Muslim. Yet in hypocrisy, we are all what we are. We insult, we are always overcritical of what people do. My brothers, that is a huge mistake. The best way, go back to what Rasulullah ﷺ did. Did Rasulullah ﷺ insult the Yahud? He didn't. The only time Rasulullah ﷺ looked at the Torah of the Jews was when the Jews were under the ruling of Islam in Al-Madinah. And they committed a zina. And whatever law was on Muslims, it was on the Jews. When they came to Rasulullah, and watch this, my brother, understand this. They were under the overruling of Islam, but the judge between them is the Torah. Is what? The Torah. Meaning, Islam is the authority, but when it comes to ruling between two Jews, if there is a problem between a Jew and a Muslim, then Islam is the code to apply. But if it is between two Jews or two Christians, the Bible is the source of law, not the Quran, the Bible. And this is at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought the two Jews and he said to them, before I issue the ruling, what is written in the Bible? And they said, nothing, we don't have a ruling. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, what is written in the Bible? And then he said, bring the Bible. And a rabbi brought the Bible, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, turn to, and this is the command of Jibreel. And they turned to a surah of their books, of their chapters, whatever. And the rabbi started reading. And when he got to the statement of al-rajm, meaning the stoning, the rabbi covered it. And Rasulullah ﷺ said, remove your finger. What's that? And that's when he asked one of the companions to learn the Hebrew language. My brother, we cannot be more clever than Rasulullah. Today, and one day we are going to pay the price for insulting Christianity. Believe me, there will be non-Muslims. They are going to be pride, even if they don't practice Christianity. But they're going to kick the hell out of every Muslim. And women will be abused in the street because we are insulting their religion. That day you wish and I wish and we all wish we had followed the Sunnah. So from now on, no more superiority business over the non-Muslims. Be a good Muslim. Don't talk about Islam. Act Islam. Don't say Allah is one to the non-Muslims and sell him everything that is Tawheed, and then you go the rest of the day breaking everything that you taught them. Don't be like that. On the Day of Judgment, you will go to Jahannam. So to avoid Jahannam today, we should not be a source of insult to Islam by insulting whatever other people insult. We must be respectful to that. We disagree with them. لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينَ. That's what we recite in Allah. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. To you is your religion and to me mine. If someone is, if your colleague works with you and he's wearing a cross in on their chest, don't you go and have a go at their thing because they're going to have a go at the Kaaba, at Islam and things like that. Be accepting, be respecting. You don't accept it. Be accepting of the person that they have different religion, and be respectful of their religion, and move on. Rasulullah ﷺ did it, and the Sahaba did it. Till tomorrow, my brothers, stay in the mercy of Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is your brother, Abdus Salam Abu Usama.